Minecraft. A game that has over 1600 items, and even the easiest items to get in game would be a struggle to get in real life. So what do you think would happen if you gave an experienced Minecraft player?
He asked me if I could teach him how to jerk.
10 minutes to get 5 items that a very, very, very regular, average Joe, run of the mill, ordinary.
Yo, bro.
Oh, shh.
For real?
My bad.
Like,
no, that's on me.
Bro, come on.
Wait, no, you don't have to. I'm good. Okay. Anyways, an experienced player, 10 minutes to get 5 items that a regular person has to get in 3 days. So let's find out what happens.
But yeah, okay. We're in a birch forest. One good thing about the game is they do have a variety of flowers and that's probably what we'll go after first. So probably an axe just in case we need more stuff. And we're also going to craft a pickaxe. We want to get things that aren't as easily accessible. We found a ravine. We got a pickaxe, right? Okay, we're straight. I really want to get into that ravine. I just don't know where. Don't know if it's really worth the time. Plus, I have to get out. Oh, never mind. It's worth the time. Okay. Like, if your mom and your girlfriend switched bodies, iron is attainable. Same thing with gold. Oh, there's coal right there, too. Cool. I mean, if we want to be full defense, let's, like, collect this, too, because what is this? Diorite? I don't ask this often, but it's like, well, I don't really ask this. Bro, it was sucking like that. You got the 5 items. What I want you to find is some coal, some ink, leather, a bone, and a lily of the valley flower. All right, good luck, bro. I'm gonna see you later. And yeah.
It's time to get to work. So I started researching and I found out that the closest lily of the valley flower were located in North Carolina. So I have 2 options. The first one being stay in Georgia, get 4 out of the 5 items, and just accept that, hey, you couldn't be great, but you were good. Or I drive 4 hours to North Carolina, I potentially get the flower, and then I make the 4-hour drive back, and I'm still not guaranteed to get the flower. And do all this because I want to be great at my Minecraft challenge. So, I mean, you can probably assume which one I picked, right? I mean, we're going to North Carolina. Woo! I think if I want to get to the forest, I have to go through here.
You've reached another that is not
service
or does not mail. Check the number and dial again.
Nah, hell no. Hey, how do I get over there? This? Bro, this shit don't look real. Bro, where am I, bro? Excuse me. Oh, my fault. Y'all good?
Yeah, now you good.
So first, I would like to ask, where am I? Like, what is this? What is that? There's like, it said it was like a national forest and it took me here.
Oh, so you have to actually leave here? You might get in trouble if you're on campus. I thought you were here. But you go there, there's gonna be a sign that's gonna say National Forest. Like, it's like literally right there.
Oh, it's on the other side.
Yeah.
Okay, thank you. Thank y'all so much. Y'all have a great day, man. I low-key wanna explore this bitch a little bit. Bro, they got like speaker phones and shit. Bro, this is like, I feel like I'm on a field trip. There's something eerie about this. This has nothing to do with my Minecraft journey. So I'll be leaving. It's a nigga driving over here in a golf cart, bro. I feel like he's about to come into Uma! Yo, he's pulling out right next to me. Hey there. We good?
You wanna help me?
Nah, I was looking for the national park and the address that took me here.
But they I thought I was coming into the national park, but they just told me it's like over there.
Yeah, they were saying that we got caught on our surveillance system. People could be arrested for trespassing and stuff.
Mm-hmm. No, I was just leaving, like, actually. I really didn't know where I was. I'm sorry about that.
All right.
Appreciate it. Yes, sir. Thank you for being understanding.
Yes, sir.
So if you look right across, you can actually see where it says Nantalahala Forest. Just the gate is closed as hell. Bro, what the fuck? Hold on, National Forest, see? Bro, this is confusing, bro. Bro, I can't pull up GPS, bro. It just keeps saying searching, and then look, bro, I'm dead, it's like stuck. Bro, this nigga just on my ass, bro. Bro, it's somebody right behind me, bro. Bro, I don't know what's going on. This nigga just been trailing me, bro, for like 10 minutes. Oh my God, I'm never doing some shit like this again. Whenever I can and feel comfortable doing it, I am pulling into someone's driveway and getting the fuck up out of here. Okay, they passed me. Yo, bro, I was so fucking scared.
Okay, checking in now. I just saw a sign that said Nantahala National Park as I've been driving. So I think I'm going in the right direction. Look. All right, I can't drive and record at the same time, but we're here.
Okay, so you probably don't know where I am. And that's because I don't either. Well, I do. I'm in the Nantalahasi Falls, but I'm not exactly where I wanted to be. It's a crazy, oh my God. Echo! Crazy. I'm at the camping lodges because this is the only place I could really find that made sense. So I'm here. I'm finna be looking for that flower now. Let's go before it gets dark and the motherfucking mountain lions come out and shit. Okay, it's a couple. Hold on. Hey there.
Hey.
Do you guys happen to know anything about flowers?
A little bit.
For real?
Maybe.
Can I come down there?
Yeah.
Is your dog friendly?
Mostly.
Okay.
Hi.
You sure he friendly? Is he really friendly? Hey, that is yet to be determined.
Come here.
Let me smell your hand.
Smell my hand?
He won't hurt you. Come on.
Yeah, hey, buddy. Hey, buddy. Would he let me pet him or no?
Yeah, he'll let you pet him.
Hey, buddy.
And then once their people are in the house, he's like their best friend.
Okay, well, I'm glad that we're good now.
Hi.
Come on over. What have you been doing out there?
I was looking for this specific one called the Lily of the Valley, and I heard that it's up here.
Should be.
Yes, but I don't know where I should look, like what type of area I should look in.
It might even be a little too early for him.
But I haven't seen him since we've been here.
So according to them, I'm like way too early. Those two were like really nice. It's not often that you just meet people that are just that nice. I feel like that really calmed me down a lot, even though like I probably failed. So even though it felt like I wasted my time on day one, I didn't put my head down. I was running through it on day two, like literally running through the challenge, like literally running.
Since I wasted like my whole day yesterday, I gotta really pick up the pace today.
So through here, and down there is a river. And they said that you can find flint by riverbeds. Oh, no, this is dead flint. Holy shit, holy shit, holy shit, holy shit, holy shit. This is dead
Flint, bro. Look at this. Oh my, yo, that has to be that. That's literally Flint. I just found Flint. We're locked. We're teed.
You're probably confused why I was so excited to get Flint.
Holy shit.
But that's because I never finished explaining. I was going to make ink by combining soot from a spoon and water from, I mean, pretty much anywhere. But in order to do this, you have to start a fire. And I was gonna start a fire with flint and steel. Yes, like Minecraft. So now that I have flint, all I need is the steel.
Hey y'all, so it's the night of day two, really the morning of day three. It's 2:46. I should not be up this late. Because I have to wake up at like 7 because I'm gonna go be meeting a blacksmith tomorrow because he has coal and leather for me. And I'm gonna be making a knife. And those three things, I'm going to get all four items in this challenge. So tomorrow, day three, that's really the day that things happen. I'ma see y'all in the morning though.
Hey.
So, what's going on? I'm doing good, how about yourself?
Okay, so I'm trying to get coal and leather, and for me to do that, or for me to get that, what do I need to do?
You're gonna need to take a river spike, and with heat and pressure in these tools, you're going to make a functional knife out of it. It's hardened and able to be used.
And if the knife doesn't work, I don't get the stuff.
Correct. You've wasted your time.
Okay. All right, let's do it.
All right.
I got it. Heat it and make it from this into this. So if you've done everything right, your shape is right, your bevel's right, your hardening is right, everything's right, and your straps are right, we should be able to cut this piece of paper quite easily.
Right? Okay.
This determines whether we have a knife or not.
So if it cuts, I pass. If it doesn't,
you're
screwed. I fail.
Yeah. All right. Ready? Look at you. You're the winner. Good job.
Hey!
About that?
My knife worked.
That looks good.
Thank you.
You like it, huh?
Yeah, I ain't never made something like this before. This is crazy. Yeah.
Okay. Here we go. You win.
Thank you.
Good judgment. You worked deliberately. You did everything you said. You followed directions. Very diligent. Very well done.
Thank you.
Leather.
Coal. And we did it.
Congratulations.
Thank you so much.
You're so welcome.
So it's time to leave Michael's workshop and head back home to start the fire.
I don't know what I'm doing. I think it's like... Bro, what the f***? Brian, go lie. This might just be a rock for real. Even though it looks like I can't use the knife for anything, I have a plan to use the knife to get me everything. Except for the flowers, we're never getting those. Spoiler alert. All right, so we've arrived at the thrift shop. The thrift shop? I'm not getting clothes. The pawn shop. I'm about to sell the f*** out this knife. I ain't gonna lie.
Do that while you're doing the work.
Yeah, I'm not gonna.
How you doing, man?
I was going, this is your business?
Yeah.
Oh, this is cool. No, I actually had something I wanted to try and sell, though.
What's that?
Well, I actually saw online, it said that this was like a family business type thing.
Yep.
Yeah. So I thought that y'all would, so this, it's a knife that my grandfather made. Like, what would you value it at?
I'm not an expert on it. You probably want to take it to a knife person.
Okay. Well, what would you buy it for?
Really don't know. I think yours is cool. It's got some, your blades kind of gotten rusted out.
Nah, it's not rusty.
If you don't wipe them down with oil, then they'll, you know, they tend to rust.
Nah, he's been keeping good care of it because he puts, so it's a method that he does. He like melts honey and he'll put it on, put the honey wax on there.
Uh-huh.
And then that's what keeps it like fresh.
Take a while to show you. So if I get a lot of them, it'll like good.
He told me he was like, cause he's getting older. So he was like, either you keep it or you sell it for me. And I was like, well.
What are you trying to
sell for? I mean, he's not like, he's not looking for anything crazy. What, 40?
Pretty cool, man. Why don't you just keep it? It's in your family. See, that side looks good.
Mm-hmm.
Pretty good. And then it should, this side should look the same.
Mm-hmm.
It's got a big pit in it.
Yeah.
What the deal is with that. Very sharp. Whoever sharpened it did a pretty good job on it.
Yeah, no, he made it.
Yeah, I know.
So yeah, I say it's definitely a very well made knife.
I don't know. What else did you have? Anything else? Would you like to put something with it?
Nah, that's all I got.
Yeah. Honestly, I don't. You got me. Because it's handmade and it's in your family. It's a tough one. I don't even know what I'd sell it for. What would I sell it for? If I bought it from you for 40, what am I supposed to sell it for?
Oh, no.
Right.
50, 60.
Yeah, it sounds about like what I would probably sell it for, to be honest with you.
That's what you would sell it for?
Yeah, about what you sell it for.
Okay, so we can go 25 so you can make profit off it.
I got 25 on it.
25?
Yeah, we'll do.
All right, we can go 25.
All right, my man. That's yours.
Thank you. Thanks. Very much. You have a good day, man.
Now it's time to start my three-step plan.
Can I get a six-piece classic?
That was 12.7.
There you go. I kind of feel bad about selling a knife, I'm not gonna lie. I was very proud to make it, but this challenge matters more. But all that being said, there's a bone. We're now Staples.
It's gonna be $2.47.
All right, cool. I'm paying in cash.
All right.
There you go. Hey. Keep the change.
Okay.
Yeah, keep the change. Real baller shit.
That's looking inky to me. Yeah! Let's go to Patrick right now.
Hey, Patrick.
Look at him.
Yo.
You're not God, by the way, just cause like, I was like,
I swear I know I'm gonna walk up the hill. This is gonna be in the sunset. I'm like, this is gonna be the most cheesy ever. Hello?
All right. First thing first, we're gonna go to the that was really hard to get. A piece of leather.
Yeah, how the did you get this?
A piece of leather and coal.
Oh, wow.
Damn. So in order to get that, I had to find a blacksmith.
For a
I made a knife.
Oh, you're done.
I'm so serious.
Oh, wow.
Wow. Then I had to sell the knife.
Oh, wow.
To a pawn shop to get a pen, and I got the ink out of it. Wow. That's the ink right there. And with the rest of the
knife, same squid ink. Mm. All right, bruh. I killed a squid for that shit. Just saying. Yes.
You want to go kill a squid in real life? All right, let's see how that works out.
Let's go scuba diving.
You can go scuba diving.
Swear, let's go scuba.
And then, with the rest of the money, I got a bone.
Where'd you get the bone from?
An archaeologist.
Are you serious? Okay, bro. With the fact that it's wrapped up, this is chicken, bro.
This is
This is dirty. This is dirty.
Kavon just ate that shit.
Yeah, bro. Cause I'm just like, I got four. Yo, bro, stop eating it like that, bro.
Got a 4 out of 5.
Achievement unlocked. Achievement unlocked.
Hey, do you know the outro?
Oh, what's the outro?
To my videos.
No, just fade to black.
He's a fake viewer.
No, I watch every single one. I just don't.
If no one else believes in you?
Oh, yeah. I believe in you. That's simple. That's your slogan. It's not an outro.
It's I do.
You didn't say that in your last video.
It's I do.
What?
It's I do. I didn't say it in the last video, did I?
You didn't. That's what I'm just saying. Like, you don't be doing that shit every... The last time... You didn't even do it in the job video.
Ooh,
what job? Nigga, I'm my wife. What? What? Where my phone at?
Bro. Pull it up. Put money on it. Put money on it.
Hey, we out. This ain't even going in the video. I believe in you.
There's a wild squirrel in its natural habitat, chewing on a nut. It's completely at peace right now, with no one to disturb it. Scary.